Anyway, somebody told about this sculptures in front of me. So they are now my friends since last 5 months, more than 5 months already. Since the lockdown has started, this was the only way as a kind of trauma counseling for me, that I could feel that we have friends, we could talk, or we are looking at each other through this webinar. So that is how I gradually improvised, because I never in my life was having a kind of a moment that I will be within four walls for a long time. So that is how I created a space. So when I thought that this frame of webinar will be a kind of space, so I wanted to have some design. So that is how within my room or in the office I got these two. And at that time there was a kind of debate came up, that live performance or digital performance, something like that. I was in support of not going for digital performances to expose to the audiences, to be available very easily in the hand of a mobile. So that is how I was waiting for a live kind of situation. Like we make phone, like we call each other by video phone. I thought this is a better video phone facility to have many people together. So that is how many different kind of options were open to use. So that is how I thought, as a mark of a kind of protest or a kind of stand or a clarity, that I want the audience to wait for the performance. So these two sculptures I have been putting in my front always to remind me that I am waiting for a time when these two will be front to front to justify that we are doing theater. So that is the introduction area which I wanted to say, because somebody asked me about the sculpture. Thank you very much, and I really very much thank Balwant Bhai, with whom we have been in touch for long, long time. I think in 2003 we went to Jammu when our play Katho was being selected to perform there in a festival by Sangeet Natak Academy. And I knew that Balwant Bhai, without knowing us, without knowing our background, he saw our play or somewhere like that, so he selected it. So that is the only time till now Natya Chetana went to Jammu and performed its play. So that is it. And then gradually I could discover that Natrang is doing something kind of searching for an Indian style of theatre. And in Bhubaneswar, there are festivals where I was involved, and I could connect to get the team here to perform, at least in two occasions. They have performed in Bhubaneswar for three times, but two times really for the public in Rabindra Mandap. So, and very interestingly, that when their play is complete, many people, they congratulated me that, oh, you got your one of your brother, I think, what you are doing in similar philosophical point of view, this Jammu group did, but very well. Then I had taken some pictures of the play, and one of the play structure was that there is a mountain where the stream is going down, and the man falls down in that at some point. So that was a very interesting scene, and when I put that photograph in our exhibition, then many people thought that, oh, it is your play. It seems to be your play, but you say you don't use any lights, but there is very colorful lights there. That our plays are mostly in the same style or same line. It may not be the same. Anyway, so when our topic is vision, about the vision, my vision on theater, I would like to give my vision titled in different steps. The first vision number one was in 1980, I was in engineering, and there was a mass ragging on me. So after this 1 year course, I left it, and then I wanted to become a movie star. It is just because I suddenly discovered that there is a course which is on drama, and two stars are there to teach them, teach the students. And they were Bijoy Mohanty and Ajit Das. And they were very popular stars at that time, heroes. And I didn't know anything about drama as a course or whatever it is. So that made me motivated to become a star, because I thought if the style would be that what they will do, I have to imitate it on the stage, so then I can be another hero, because they are heroes. So that is how I wanted to join. So I joined the course. Then 1981 to 82, within 1 year, my vision changed about theater. My vision changed because I thought that, oh, these people are trained in many other things, not only acting. They know how to do or use theater, acting with the music, with costumes, with the space design, with the lights, and with many, many other things. So I discovered, because I was a good student, and I was in science, so my parents were science veterinarian and teacher, so they our home is a science oriented home. So I discover a big science is behind theater. So that is how I wanted to be a very studious learner. I got convinced that theater vision is that we have to be a good actor, and to be a good actor you have to know all the elements of theater. It is not only acting. Acting is a small part out of that. So that is how, for that I enjoyed. Then vision number three came 82-83. I discovered that my taste of theater was mostly around entertainment. But now I discovered that there is a very different kind of aesthetic value. So there is a kind of art in theater. So it is not simply only the techniques, because I became a student, so that is a serious student. So I studied everything from a science point of view. But it was not simply scientific machine like techniques. It was rather an expression of aesthetics. So I, my vision became theater is an art with a very a deeper level aesthetic sense. Then vision number four came 1984 to 1990. Suddenly I discovered in a national service scheme, I was a social worker by mentality from very beginning, because my parents were veterinary surgeon and a girls' school teacher. So they have been posted in very remote places out of the townships. So in that way, they were doing kind of social service with poor people. And I was a good scout, and then I became an NSS volunteer. So that is how, with that spirit, I was the leader of the NSS team of Utkal Sangeet Mahavidyalaya, which have drama to other departments, like 13 different departments. We did a play of 10 minutes in a social service camp. And at the end, we thought we are entertaining them, and we are giving our art as an entertainment for the slum dwellers. Then the slum dwellers next day became very much annoyed with us. They said, you are criticizing us through your play. I said, how come? It was just a kind of artistic exploration. They said, no. It is it is a criticism about our unity and all that. Then I thought, oh, people are drawing attention to the subject of the play rather than the art of the play or aesthetics of the play. So that is how it became a challenge as a student to think that, oh, I was thinking that there are two types of theater. One vision is for art vision, and another is entertainment vision. There are two types of practices, but no, there is another type, which is to make the people aware about the subject more. So there may be art, there may be entertainment, but the awareness part, the education part, the subject, what is inside the content, content is more important. So that is how I started searching a form to fit to this type of third angle, that how can we do a play using art and entertainment, but the people at the end will draw attention to the subject, forgetting the art and aesthetics. But during the play, they should be involved inside the art and aesthetics. So that is how it became a research subject, and I tried to search, and I met, somebody said that street theater is a form like that. So I was visiting NSD at that time, because I discovered that my teachers have got a training from a school called National School of Drama. So I wanted to see that. So that is how I was going to Delhi sometimes when there was little money with me, then I used to go. So somebody said that the street theater master is Safdar Hazmi. So you should meet him. So I met Safdar Hazmi, but at the end he said, that are you a Communist Party member? I said no. Then he said no, I can't give training on that for those who are not Communist Party members. So I said no, I don't want to do politics. I want to do a kind of art where people at the end will draw attention to the subject. That's my research subject. Then she said no, I can't help. So then I became worried. He said, Subodh, do you think that theatre is not a political action? When you will realize this, then you please write to me back. So that was the condition with Safdar Hazmi in 1987. Then I came to know that Badal Sarkar is the another teacher who gives training for these kind of people, and Safdar also was being trained by him. But for me, Badal Sarkar was the writer of Baki Itihas, Ebang Indrajit and Pagla Ghoda, so I thought he's a very big shot, and I can't touch him without offering any kind of flight fare and all that luxury. But it was not that. I took 1.5 years to every day drop in a box in a pot 10 rupees, 20 rupees, 30 rupees, something like that. And then when it was 3,500 rupees, because the Indian Airlines said that up and down is 3,000 around. So then I went to Badal Sarkar thinking that he would be in a very big bungalow, but it was just a small lane, and I met him. He was having lungi and ganji or something like that, and he met me, and I asked him, I want to meet Badal Sarkar. He said, I am Badal Sarkar. I was surprised, but I saw him the same pot where I was collecting, to make him convinced that I can't pay anything else, only a flight fare. So he laughed. He said, no, don't worry. I'm a third class person. But if you have, you can give me a train fare to go, and I want to visit you. So that, like that, he came 3 times to Bhubaneswar in his life for theatre. It was by the invitation of Natya Chetana. And he could really give us a kind of light, giving a meaning that yes, theater is a political action, but it is not a party-based political action. It is a people's politics we always carry in a theater, because there is always a conflict between two different thought, two different sources, two different stand. So that is how, and at the end, we want to promote one of the vision. So that is how it should be a political action as a subject, but it should carry art and aesthetics in it. So then he again said that for art and aesthetics, this auditorium-based Western drama process in proscenium theatre, what is practiced, is not Indian theatre. So we must make our theatre free from this aesthetic, which is also a political action on the stage. So that is how it was a vision changed, that theatre is a very important element. Then we perceived in 1992 that theatre, as our vision number 6 is that theatre is a capsule. To remember that we used to have only tablets for our diseases. But why the capsule came? The capsule came only because the patients were not very much interested to take this bitterness of the powders by tablets. So it was being covered with a cover, very decorative, very colorful, very designed. And earlier there was also a sugar coat on the capsules. Now it is not there, but the design is there to give the patient, so that the patient will take it easily. But the target is not to make him happy by giving like a chocolate, but it should go inside and treat the disease. The objective is to treat the disease. It is not to make happy the patient. So that is how theatre is just like that. Theatre ras utpatti, the emotion. When we create the emotion among the audiences, then that is a kind of attempt that we are making them happy or entertained, but with a cover. It is just a kind of bahana hai hamati. It's a kind of pretension. But inside, the content is the powder which has to treat the society, the mind of the people. So that is how we perceived, our vision became changed, that theater is a capsule. And secondly, we perceived another role of theater in our vision became a tree, the process of a tree. The tree becomes the social changing process. Like, for example, because for us the subject was very important. So when you see a tree, there has roots, one branch, and then again branches, main trunk, and then branches, then the leaves, then the flower, then the fruits. So that is a tree. In this, the main important point is that the root is the mind of the people. Then the mind of the people get united to create a trunk, like a kind of attempt, a united effort, so that they share the responsibility afterwards to make a forward of their attempt, so there becomes leaf, flower or fruits at the end as a result of this united effort. So if this is the life circle, then where is theatre? For me, theatre is the water for the mind of the people. So if you figure out a tree and a water, a canal or a pot of a jug of water, then this jug is the theatre giving water to the mind of the people. So in this way, we thought it is very important part of the theatre as for the community to give water to the tree of a social changing process, just like real water for the trees. Without water, no tree can survive. So that is how we made our vision clear for that. Then the third part of the vision, this section in 1992, was that theatre is a freedom struggle. It is a freedom struggle. It is a struggle on the stage to make the style free from the Britishers. And again, on the content for the public, it is a freedom struggle to make the society free from the evil spirits. So it is a freedom struggle. So Then vision number 7 came up in 1993 when we discovered, because of these 3 points, this vision pushed us to go to villages to search what is Indianness. Then we could interact with tribal culture. We could get closer to the nature. We could discover that the folk style is the mother and the treasury of theater. It is when there is no practice, no theory comes up. It never comes that first theory and then practice. So if we say that 2,500 years old, we have Natya Shastra, the theater manual book, then there has to be practice before. So this, that before structure of theater is what? That is folk theater. And till now, we have in Orissa more than 15 types of very interesting, very different folk theater forms in villages existing more than 300, 400, 500 years. And what Bertolt Brecht said, what Stanislavski said, what any other persons outside India said, are already in practice and still existing in Orissa in villages. Even anybody comes today can see it. But in Bertolt Brecht's group, what Bertolt Brecht was believing and doing, that has gone gradually out. What Stanislavski was thinking in Moscow Art Theatre, it has gone out. But we have that. And we have that before their fathers gave them a birth. So it is, they are of 18th century, 19th century people, but we have things more than 500 years in our hand. So that is how we are very much, we became more interested, village, tribal culture, nature, folk style, everything as our mother. I always say that this cotton design, Sambalpuri design, who has invented it? This is invented by illiterate weavers. Our Konark temple sculpture, it is done by 1200 illiterate carpenters. Our Pattachitra is being practiced by illiterate villagers. Anything you think, just you think, we have now classical musical instruments, but a branch will be there, and there will be 2 leather points, and if you beat like this, it will be a drum effect. Who has invented this? Who has discovered this? This is discovered 1,000 years before by some Adivasis who used to move in jungles, who has access to leathers and wood and all that. So that is how we became more closer to the nature as our mother, villagers. And we have seen in our team, there are city young people who wanted to become stars or anything kind of to build up a kind of career in theater. They join, and also we get tribal young people who have never seen a theater, to whom we carry to Bhubaneswar to show theater in there. So these two groups, they mix together in our team. And when there is a dance step to be learned, the Adivasi boys and girls, they pick up within 10 minutes, which a city-based young person who always dance on the movie songs and marriage ceremonies and all that, they take a dance step to learn for minimum 4-5 days. This is the big difference between nature and there. I always say that God, if He is the greatest creator, He has created all the designs of the world. You cannot find a straight line in His creation in this world. Everything is based on curved lines. A creature, leaf, water, cloud, everything is based on Vakra Rekha, curved lines. But whatever straight line you see in your front, it is all man-made, which is also not their creation. God has given the sense of straight line, by the end of all curve lines at the end, which we call as horizon, that is the only invisible straight line God has given us, the sense, that we are scoring in different spaces. So I always think that a drama course or a drama training should not be within the straight line of a house. It should be within as much as closer to the curve lines. Then the learners will get more and more ideas of new discoveries, so more visuals. So that is how the vision became more clear, that we must learn from the nature. Then vision number 8 came when in 1993, when this political angle, the aesthetic angle, everything come closer, then we started believing. Our vision became that artists, particularly theatre artists, their personal life and professional theatre life should not be separated, because people are observing us even outside the stage. If you are portraying a character of Rama, then they don't accept you mentally, that you come out and you drink alcohol outside the auditorium or smoke constantly outside the auditorium after portraying the character of Rama on the stage. It takes time. That is how actually our many of the actors, they have become politicians, because people believe their character image as their personal image, like same. So that is how we must not differentiate between these two things separately, because we are observed. So this is a kind of vision that our theatre practitioners, actors, should demonstrate what they believe in their own personal life, which has to have a sync, which has to be having a kind of connection, what they believe on content of on the stage. So what we tell others, we need to practice. That was our kind of vision. So in 1987, when we did a play against a tea company in Kalahandi district, where the tea company was destroying our environment and making it as a tea garden, and in Odisha there was no tea practice before, and it's only Britishers, British company, Brooke Bond and Lipton company, which spreaded the market here by giving a teaching how to make tea and how to drink tea, just with a tagline that your king is drinking this tea when they meet our British officers. So that was the key line which motivated the Odisha population to get into the trap of the tea garden and tea. So we did a play against that, so we wanted to practice this. So we left tea from 1987 till today, and our campus is free from tea. That doesn't mean that we don't take any hot drinks. So we have Pancharasa, like title, having 5 different juices, which is now in this corona season. It is a big demand, and it is propagated in the name of kadha, that you have to drink kadha every time. So that is a practice since 1987 we do in theatre campus in Natyagram. And this, to connect life, personal life and theatre life, we wanted to establish that we must have our own life and own village separately to practice. Otherwise, all these outside environment will pollute us one day, one someday. So we purchased 5 acres of land to make our own village, where we can practice and do and live together 35 kilometers away from Bhubaneswar. And we developed it as a theatre village. And the name also was being given Natyagram, meaning theatre village. Then theatre is our vision became more enlarged, speculated, like theatre is more a process than a product. So how theatre is chosen, how theatre is conceived, how theatre is made, with whom theatre is made, for whom theatre is made, all these how is the process, which is more important than a product at the end. If the process will be more sensitively done, then the product will automatically be nice out of it. So that is how we thought that we must have a sensitive approach in the process of theater performance. Then we discover two styles. One, a style called psychotheater, we titled, because we carry a theater by bicycle, crossing hundreds of kilometers to reach the remote villagers, and there we perform in the daytime about 40 minutes and then move on one village to another village, and we perform it with all research in background for aesthetics. It seems to be a street theater, but it is not a street theater for propaganda of anything. It is giving a kind of reflection of the life of the same area. And aesthetically, we give so much of importance that we go for the same area before to live with the people, to get their stories, their political stand, their history, their psychology, their colors, their musical instruments, their songs, their stories, and their real life incidents. And we come back and design the play accordingly. So all our 51 plays till today have gone to our villages, have all different costume design, property design, it's song design. There are plays which is there for the south, where the changu is the main musical instrument. And the play for the Mayurbhanj is having all madal as the main instrument. If it is a Kalahandi play, it is all in drums, dhol. So like that, we have a variety of design and everything to do the plays for the villages, which many times people misunderstand us that we are doing a propagandistic street theater, but it is not. And we wanted to enlighten the urban area about the power of rural, so we enlarge those rural life-based plays for the urban public, because we committed that we will do all original plays, we will not do any translation plays in Natya Chetana. And second, many writers are living in city, so they do always play about the city life. So there are very less people who do write play about the rural life or tribal life. So we committed ourselves for this area to do theatre for the masses. For us, our play, the vision became clear that our theatre has to be for a mass, not for a class, not for a limited class or intellectual class. And the theatre will be done not by only talents, it's by any common person. So we developed a system of training to do theatre by non-artists also, to whom people never think of an artist. So that is how our theatre became for the masses, by the masses, and it is of the masses, because the aesthetics which we choose, it has to be available and self-reliant all the way. So our settings never goes for any carpenter to be hired to spend money outside. Our settings is made out of bamboo sticks and bamboos. The play which we carried from Odisha to Jammu, the Katha play, was involved with 250 bamboo sticks and 8 feet bamboos, and with scout knots to tied it by ropes, so that we erect a stage within 3-4 hours by the artists, not by any carpenter, to perform on that, and to collapse it is 1 hour to carry that forward. And this can be carried by with us like a luggage by making bundles of bamboo sticks of 6 feet on the train. So that is how we are making the play belonging to the mass and to make it more self-reliant. So it has to be connection and communication with the people. And the vision 10 came that when we do theatre, in Orissa we have 61 types of tribal people. They speak more than 20 more than 20 languages which nobody can understand each other. So when we make a theater, it's already more than 2-3 mother tongue practitioners in a team, because we collect people from different districts as a temporary volunteer. That is how we started doing theater through visuals mostly. So we wanted to score the visual mostly. But that doesn't mean that we want to do only mime theater. We want to do a complete normal theater where a audience who is blind can also enjoy with our music and dialogue modulation, the spirit of the dialogue. They can understand and enjoy it. And if somebody knows the language, they can really understand the game of the words. And then again, for the deaf and dumb who never hear it, they can see the emotional accents and visuals used with a proper design to enjoy the play from beginning to the end. So nobody should say that I can't understand. So very fortunately, within a journey of 20 years, we performed our Odia play in Odia, in Maharashtra, in Mumbai, and all the before the only Maratha audience, and they were just like reacting as if they know Odia language. We did the play in Chennai in a festival, and every scene, every moment, they were reacting just like Odia people. And there was a big debate when we wanted to take the Odia play to Europe, where there is nobody, there will be no Indians in the audiences. And we participated in 2-3 festivals in two, three, four times, crossing boundary of 4-5 languages, performing in 4-5 countries, like France in French, and Italian, Netherlands, Dutch, and Luxembourg, Germany, Finland, Finnish, Norway, Norwegian. So all these, but we never allowed any translation. They demanded that please give your script and we will make subtitles. We said no, and no disclosure of the stories before. So because Indian theater lives with anxiety to carry on. And we said that let the visuals convey. And it has happened like that. And it was crossing. That is why the same group, once invited, they repeated the next time. So this is the proof that we can convey and have a connection with the general mass, with the emotional impact, by using our Indian methodology of visuals. So I say always that theater, people come to see a play. When we do theater, we are doing a play, please come to see our theater. So when you say that, please come to see our theater, why we want to make them hear our theater? It is more important that we should, we have invited them for a lunch, so we should not give them only breakfast. So it has to be a kind of really food for the eyes, not a simple food for the ear. So that is how our vision of the theater is a travel like this. I have just 2-3 more points to tell about the future. So for future vision, we have thought of that theater has to be a regular feature of everyone's life, just like we are proposing for yoga or exercises, all that. Theater is a very good personality building exercise to help any profession. Very recently, I saw an advertisement that Vamanji is going to conduct some kind of voice exercise, and who are the target, including that they have written lawyers also can join this course. Very interesting. I have never thought lawyers could be trained in theater voice to really put it in place when they are arguing. So that is how I think everybody's life, a salesman, a manager, whoever is there, Everybody can get help by theater as an exercise. So it's a personality building exercise, which is already now scored by corporates to do theater workshop with the managers, with the clerks, with the other supervisors, etc. But for me, our target could be children, school, theater in schools, women who are now, who should really express their stand, and the students in general, particularly in, I don't know outside Odisha, but in colleges, there is a kind of elected body formats where there is a post called dramatic secretary and assistant dramatic secretary and president dramatic society. So these are three posts getting elected. People are getting elected. It's a very long history that there is a dramatic society always there, elected, and money is collected from each student for that society to run. And they conduct every year one drama, and they were having a cultural evening at least once a year as an annual drama. So that is the same money is now being used under the name of cultural evening. It is not, there is no practice of drama. But if you see our history of theater in Orissa, at least all the major breakthrough of theater has happened by the lecturers, because at least they have students as their actors, and they have opportunity for their theater for the event of the theater. So theater in colleges and dramatize. The other future vision is to democratize the theater making process itself. It should not be a dictatorial process. It should be a democratic process of making, democratic process of economy. Everybody should share the economy of the theater, and the political and cultural part inside theater should be also democratized. There should not be any hidden agenda, and there should not be a there should be transparency and all that. Then the future vision is that theater could be promoted with the victims who are victims of any injustice or any kind of problems. They should try to do theater, just like Augusto Boal was doing theater with the farmers when he was developing this forum theater idea. Then actors, A, artist, C, creator, T, teacher, O, organizer, R, researcher. With all these elements, people should take acting or action with a very serious approach, with a sensitive approach, and own the theater. Always, many times, the directors own a theater, or a playwright owns a theater, but actors should really own a theater process, because they are the people who make it run. Then cross the boundary of languages, cross the boundary of anything, and ventilate the emotion through the visual theater as a language. That's a future vision I have. And the final title of the vision for me is that make theater as an essential element of everybody's life, like yoga, and make the image of theater, make the social political image of theater to feel proud to say that I am doing theater. Just like many people say, I am doctor, I am engineer, I am IS, I am this officer, I am manager, I am an owner of a company. Like that, we should do theater and say that I am doing theater. So that has to be our stand at the end in a long-term vision. Otherwise, people think, ye theater karta hai, matlab gaya. So the theater person is a gone case. They will be very indisciplined, they will not treat the people well, and they will be very different, very unusual. All these things comes with a very deteriorate manner in comparison to other professions or other engagements or other personalities. So we must make our image front. So that's the vision of theatre. I think I will take some questions if you have, and I will try to read it and try to say. But I am not really a very good expert in. I'm a very village-based rural theatre workers, like kind of thing. And the question is, why you have chosen rural theatre? Rural theatre. Is there a specific reason, sir? Yes, I mean, I said it before, perhaps you jumped it. I said that the mother of theatre lives in rural areas and tribal areas. It is the rural nature. So in these days, I am propagating that Corona has given many kind of indications to go back to nature. People are happy in Delhi looking at Himalaya from a distance. People in Banaras are happy that now fishes are very cleanly observed very close to the Ganga corner. Now many trees are very happy that nobody is coming to cut them. Now in Bhubaneswar, we are hearing the sound of the birds when there is lockdown. So like this, Corona is giving an indication how we feel better when we come closer to the nature. And finally, in theatre, everything. In art and culture, like voice, we have Saregama in vocal. Where this comes? It comes from different birds and all that, from the nature. The taal, the rhythm, is coming from the nature. So our everything is from the nature. The inventors are with nature. What we are doing now are always with the nature. The kapda, ye kapde ka, jo the cloth, the inventor of the cloth is not from the urban area. All the urban area lives on the basis of the rural area. Rural area gives us food. Rural area gives us light. Rural area gives us everything what we live on. So that is how. But unfortunately, the main so-called mainstream well-known people are belonging to city, and people are controlled by the policy or made in the city. So that is how many artists are not having any access to any resources in this Corona period also. So Corona has already given an indication, because now there is a declaration that if you go for an outdoor performance, you can perform before maximum 100 people after the September goes off. So that means what? Open air. So you have to come closer to the people, breaking the walls. They are afraid of making a gathering inside house. So we need to go back to the nature. Theater is waiting to go back to the nature. What Badal Sarkar was telling like that, now the Corona Sarkar is doing telling that. So what Badal Sarkar said, go to the people, go for open air, break the walls and come out. Now Corona Sarkar is telling, come out, go to the people. Thank you very much. Next. Question. I can't get any questions more. Okay, so if there is, if I'm clear about my vision. Do we expect nature from our realization? Yes, yes. Everybody can have, your body can be also in city, but in mind you can be also in nature. You can, then you search to how to go closer to the nature physically. But first you must think that I can be out of this AC room. I can be out of these cars. I can be out of this crowd effects. so that we can really love nature and we can do things within the nature. You know, in this kind of corona situation, even when I was taking bath alone in the bathroom, suddenly my hair became more long because I have not gone to a barber shop yet. So it was very less and gradually it became long. So what I did, I started playing theater with them. I make soap on my face and I put my hairs in different style and started taking photographs. I have a series of 20 photographs of 20 different styles. Then I started cooking in my kitchen room. I interpret that as my rehearsal room. I started interpreting that all masalas, all elements of theater, all elements of vegetables and all that, they are my actors. And Chula is my stage. So I try to prepare a play, means I rehearse it. Then I put that in a plate to come to my dining space to eat, and that is my performance space. And with all this, I started making designs. I put many similar bottles with labels, like giving actors with some character. I put that in a particular shelf. Then I made a rule where to keep what, which has to go to fridge, which has to go to store, which has goes to the corner, which has to be there, which is closer to the streamline, the water line. Everything, I started making it like a design. When I serve it, after the rehearsal, means after the cooking is finished, when I serve in a plate, then I put in a particular design of the color that, okay, saag hai, matlab is a green. So the green saag will be in the corner. That means I should not put another dark color nearby. There has to be dal or something like that, which has to break the line. And then another color after that. Then I try to put many things. I used to take only very simple food of 1, 2, 3, 4 things. But I try to put colors like some pampad. Pampad is circular and it's yellowish. So I intentionally I do pampad someday to put a color in my plate in a proper design. So like that, we can play with our nature even though we are alone. We can do theater. Nobody can stop a theater person from thinking because it is just like water. We are just like water. Water cannot be jailed. Water cannot be prisoned. It has to be dynamic. It will break anything. Anything. I many times say that if sometimes I will be imprisoned, if I will be putting inside jail, then that will be my great time because I will have many actors around. And I can continuously do theater without worrying who is coming, where to take food and where to place the rehearsal and all that. Everything I will be in my hand. So we cannot stop ourselves. It has to go run. So we will be definitely winning the race at the time because nobody can stop us. Corona cannot stop us. Thank you. Even I have some interest to work with villagers and tribals, but challenges of basic survival amenities comes in between. How to overcome with it? First of all, have you seen Discovery Channels? Discovery Channels, very popular channel in television serials, television channels. I see them, that these people, they go for any extreme to eat, any extreme to sleep anywhere, any extreme to do anything. In my young time, if I today fix my idea that I have to see this movie on the first day, it is Amitabh Bachchan's play, I have to see it, then I create my own ways in many, many ways. I may lose my shirts when I struggle for a ticket or whatever it is. I can pay double and things like that. So I always say that I have never seen a beggar making suicide. But a big person having millionaire like person can die, like the wife of Shashi Tharoorji, who died in a hotel, paying every night 1 lakh rupees per night, a higher charge, just because the house was under coloring, but she made suicide. But a beggar in India never makes suicide. Why? Because the real beggar, I don't talk about the false beggars. There are many false beggars who have other income sources. But the beggar who moves from place to beg and eat, who doesn't have a guarantee of tomorrow how to live, who doesn't have a guarantee of what to wear tomorrow, where to sleep tomorrow. In my struggling time, I have slept 15 days in platform, railway platform. And I have seen many, many beggars, they come and sleep there. Even they pay something to the policeman there. So this is the life. So you can do anything. No survival questions is there. You can survive with any, and if you go to real tribal people and rural people, you will never stay without food. You will never stay without any problem of sleeping. When we make cycling, you know, crossing kilometers and kilometers, in these places there is no room at all where to sleep for 20 people or 15 people. What we do? In a big row of the verandas, everybody sleep on the verandas in front to front different houses. And sometimes some small rooms. Aajkal to abhi to panchayat ka room ho gaya hai. There are many panchayat rooms where there is a community hall or something like that. But we sleep and we never get, and we do take food what people offer. And they, for them, rice and dal is maximum. And they know that the rural, the city people in the coastal belt, they get some vegetables in the dal called dalma. So they put sometimes some kind of papayas and something like that, just to think that they will make it dalma. But we have counted. Day one, everybody's weight is this. And at the end of the cycle expedition of 15 days, every day cycling for about 100 kilometers, 20, 25 kilometers, performing 4 performances in the whole day. But after 15 days, after 50 shows is performed, when they come back after 300 kilometers cycling, then their all weight is above, not down. So we have done 700 kilometers cycling, performing 70 performances on the way, having just food from the villages. And we say them that nobody has helped them to come to you. So please, you have to give us something. We are not going to do it performance free of cost. It is not sponsored by government. It is not sponsored by anybody to come to you. We have raised fund to make the theater ready. That's it. So that is it. Thank you very much. And how many types of theater? I don't know. I think everybody have a different styles of theater. In general, in India, you know that we have 500 years of old folk theater traditions and folk performances. And Britishers came, and also even in Orissa, there is example like during Mughal time, during Muslim rule, we also have a kind of farce impact, and we have a form also with Mughal and Orissa culture mixed version, Mughal Tamsa. We say it Mughal Tamsa. So that is also there, which is 600 years old. And there are proscenium theatre, which is there for 200 years more. And people who wanted to make the Britishers happy, they imitated rather. If not, they couldn't make real proscenium theatre, but they make many different kind of theatre spaces just by imitating the proscenium, having many difficulties in the backstage. So that is what also has come, and which is now ruling as a modern theatre. So for me, there was a wave when people of India, very big sorts, like senapatis, like persons like Kanhaiya Lal ji, Badal Sarkar ji, Habib Tanbir ji, Vivekanand ji, this kind of batch, they wanted to make the theatre free from Britishers. And the next generation came up like Bansi Bhai, Ratan ji, Prasanna Bhai, all these people, the next generation also. And I count Balwant Bhai also in that line, that who also wanted to create another stream of modern Indian theatre. And we became a sainik, a soldier of that line, of that force at the end part. So we started our experimentation 1992 and we became clear after 1996. Then 1986, Natya Chetna was being established. 95-96, we got a clarity what kind of styles we have. Anything else? नमस्ते. बहुत सारे लोग इसी बीच में कुछ हेलो बोले हैं, नमस्ते बोले हैं. मैं हर एक को नाम पुकार के बोल नहीं सकता शायद, बट स्टिल आई रियली रिस्पेक्ट एंड आई एम वेरी मच हैप्पी दैट यू ऑल आर हियर एंड लिसनिंग टू मी माय विजन. इट्स नॉट ए वेरी 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 ग्रेट विजन, बट वाट एवर आई परसीव in my life, because I don't do any kind of other engagements, like no cinema. I was in cinema for before I got into full time for some time, but I left it. So but after that, after 1987, I became really completely full time. I don't do anything for television, I don't do anything for movie, I don't do anything for any commercial theater. We have Jatra, which is a commercial industry. It's a very big industry. So many politicians are owning their Jatra. Many big corporates, they have their own Jatra parties. So, but I never do anything from that. I don't have any income from that sources. And I leave. The best part is that I have been leaving without any guarantee of a job. Natya Chetna is not a beneficiary of salary grant from Government of India, because we say that this theatre cannot be a place of salary holders. In Natya Chetna, there is no holiday list, there is no attendance register, there is no leave application, there is no office timing. Like this we have been living. But we have an office structure, we have our reporting system, we have accounts, we have everything what normally other offices are doing. But we are volunteering. थैंक यू मोहम्मद भाई. हमारा काम कुछ काम में आ सकता है तो बहुत अच्छा है. सो इट आई रियली अप्रिशिएट. सो प्लीज टेल मी व्हेन टू वाइंड अप और यस इट इज आई थिंक जस्ट गेटिंग इनटू 1 आवर और समथिंग लाइक दैट. I am very much fortunate, really all these vision, what I shared, these are all contributed by many, many people during my processes. Like, you know, Satish Bhai is there. So I remember 1984 when the central government wanted to have a second generation of these senapatis. They wanted to have a scheme for 10 years to give fund for creating plays in Indianness, Indian theatre. But it is a assistance to only young theatre directors. There is an age. So they wanted to have a next generation of this thinking. So because there was no answer, who is there after Badal Sarkar or Kanhaiya Lal ji or Abhi Tanbir, Vivekanand ji, after them, who is there? So they wanted to promote this idea. Then the 1984 East Zone Theatre Festival was first organized in Bhubaneswar and Chakrabyuha of Ratan Thiamji was scheduled for the first show in Bhubaneswar on the last day of the festival. And there, Videsya by Satish Bhai was performed in Bhubaneswar first time. And Probidda, Probir Guha, alternative living theatre from Calcutta, he did his Ahalya first time here. So all these people we have seen, and there was a reflection seminar every day. On the last day, the murder of Indira Gandhi stopped the performance of Chakrabyuha in Bhubaneswar. So it was being promoted directly to perform in the national festival. But this was a big eye-opener to us, and we could believe that it is now getting into a movement by Sangeet Natak Academy to create the next generation. So we applied in the same scheme in 1992 after the training of Badal Sarkar to do the play Katha. So Katha is the first play of discovery which we named afterwards is an intimate theatre. This intimate theatre doesn't mean only space. It is mental intimacy, spiritual intimacy and everything. So it is a kind of connection between theatre and different persons. So that is how all these people have contributed to create this kind of vision. It is a very significant but very particular contributions. Okay, so I think with this, let us come to an end. Can you give a signal, Balwant Bhai? Or anybody from Natrang, if you are okay with this session. Actually, I'm a little bit under energy. I just recovering from typhoid fever. So nice. I will go through these comments afterwards. Many people have written many things. There was only one question which was pinned that I have answered. That's it. Patra Namaste. Aapne bahut acha likha. Sumit Bhai, bahut acha. Thank you. Thank you. So many people have come. So let us say bye to each other, and can we meet sometime? And all are welcome to Theatre Village, Natyagram, because Natyagram is just by legal purpose is owned by Natya Chetna, but it is a place for all those who really believe in life and theatre together. It's a community life. So since morning 6:30, 7 o'clock morning prayer, common prayer to the end, we are engaged mentally and physically in different sessions, different interactions, and Nataraj is there. And I take this privilege that we are not propagator of a typical Hinduistic approach, but for me, I felt first fortunate to get Nataraj, because only in our religion of Hindu, there is a god of theatre, so not Raj. So for me, it's a symbol of theatre god. So like that, we have put Nataraj as there as a kind of place in front of the stage, and I think he is the Malik, he is the owner of the land, and we are all servant. So we are just the guardians, guards, and soldiers of Nataraj. So for me, spiritualism and is a very interesting another kind of vision or perception about theater. That people believe theater is a very trustful game. When you declare that on such date there is a performance in this auditorium, then it becomes a kind of commitment to perform, and many audiences, they believe that there will be performance, and all the 20 people rehearsing, they will also believe that we can perform and we will be all stable. But in this era, when there is 100 insurance company gives us a feeling that you have dangers all the way, your house is in danger, your fingers are in danger, your head is in danger, your health is in danger, so you should get insurance from us. In this kind of all danger ideas, we believe that nothing is going to stop us by living and doing practice in theater and perform it. So we sell our tickets, we get our sponsors, and the audiences come also. So that is how it's a very big, this, who gives them this guarantee to us? For me, it is the great spirit which gives us the confidence that yes, I have to live up to that point at least to perform. And I have never gone through any such drastic experiment, incident that for somebody's, personal problem, the theater is stopped. Never. So, for us, spiritualism also is a very incorporate. So that is how I really pray theater God of theater, Nataraj, every time. And 1989, when I heard a song in the National School of Drama convocation written by Ratan Thiamji, O Nata Devata. So after that, we adopted that as our prayer. So we do that prayer without his knowledge for a long time. Since that, till today, many of the participants who come and stayed in Natyagram knows Nata Devata Geet Subah Bolte Hain. Every day morning we practice that. And we just got contact and connected to Ratanji very recently, within just last 4 or 5 years only. But we discovered, we said them, sir, this is a surprise for you, that you please, without your knowledge, we have been reciting your song in the same tuning, because in that chorus one Uriya person, Gajendra Nayak, was there. So we asked him to teach us the tuning. So we are doing that till today. So spiritualism is also a very big belief inside theater. It is nothing to do with any religion. We get people from all religion to us. So many foreign students, they come also, and there is a Finnish girl, Saturanta Tirk, who has done a PhD on Natya Chetana. So that is how we have been connected to many international forums, universities and all that. And many have appreciated our process and invited us to direct plays, to perform and all that. So spiritualism and a kind of connection is a very important feature that we must, based on that, we must believe each other. It's a trust game. Okay, how to say bye? I don't know. I think many are there who know these features which I said. I have shared this in different platforms and different ways at different point to make me more transparent. So, okay, thank you very much. So, I said again, please visit our theater village anytime. It's a place for all sincere theater workers who are doing theater for really for theater purpose, to really highlight the theater for the public, for in general mass. So it should not be confined within a class. We want the class and mass, everybody together. So in our plays, there is a Rikshawala as an audience, and there is a very eminent theatre personality also as an with the same spirit they take it. So thank you very much. I now conclude it. Thank you. Thank you very much.